The best way to learn how to read a cash flow statement is to go through real-life examples of companies you have heard of. Let me show you in this video what a cash flow statement is and how the cash flow numbers look for Tesla. I don't own shares in Tesla, nor do I own a Tesla car. One or both of these might change in the future. If so, I will let you know in the comments below this video. Let's start with the purpose of the cash flow statement. What a company shows by publishing a cash flow statement in an annual report is how they got from the cash balance on January 1st, on the previous balance sheet, to the cash balance on December 31st, the latest balance sheet. The increase or decrease between the January 1st and December 31st cash balance is called cash flow. It consists of three categories: cash from operating activities, cash from investing activities, cash from financing activities, or terms with slight variations on that wording. We will review Tesla's cash flow statement for 2016. Tesla started the year with $1.2 billion in cash and cash equivalents and ended the year with $3.4 billion. The total cash flow was therefore a net cash inflow of $2.2 billion. Now, where did that $2.2 billion in cash flow come from? Cash from operating activities was an outflow of $100 million or $0.1 billion. In finance, we put negative numbers between brackets. Cash from investing activities was an outflow of $1.4 billion. Cash from financing activities was an inflow of $3.7 billion. So that's the top level cash flow picture. Tesla attracted financing in the form of debt or equity, which allowed them to invest. Tesla ended the year with more cash than they started with, to continue investing and running everyday operations. Now we go one level deeper, discussing each of the cash flow categories. Cash from operating activities will take the vast majority of the attention. Cash from investing activities and cash from financing activities are fairly straightforward for Tesla in 2016. Cash from operating activities is roughly the cash inflow from customers paying the company, minus the cash outflow of the company paying for purchases from suppliers, minus the cash flow of salaries paid to employees, and minus the cash outflow of taxes paid to governments. For most mature companies in good health, the cash flow from operating activities is a net cash inflow. Tesla is a fast-growing company in an early phase of its growth curve. It's therefore very understandable that cash from operating activities is not yet positive. CFOA was a cash outflow of $124 million in 2016. What were the main items in that? Tesla and many other companies use the indirect method of cash flow reporting. You start with a net income, or in Tesla's case, net loss of $773 million for the year, and then make adjustments to reconcile that net loss to CFOA. Let's step back for a minute and talk about profit versus cash flow. The way you measure profitability is different from the way you measure cash flow. In the profit view of a company, the matching principle is very important, matching the revenue and expenses to the period in which they occur. In the cash flow view of a company, the moment when cash is flowing in and cash is flowing out of the company is key. Both views give you insights into the financial performance of a company. Which adjustments are needed to go from net income to CFOA? It's a long list. Let's walk through the biggest line items in terms of monetary amount. First off, depreciation and amortization. This number was deducted as a cost when net income was calculated in the profit and loss statement, but as you do not pay depreciation and amortization to anybody, it is what we would call in finance a non-cash expense, you have to add back the amount if you want to get to a cash flow based view. The second adjustment is stock-based compensation. This is similar to depreciation. Stock-based compensation was recorded as a cost when preparing the profit and loss statement, but as it is a compensation that is paid in stock and not in cash, we need to adjust for this to get to a cash flow based view. The next six line items, each of them below $100 million, are of a similar nature. They are a plus or minus in calculating net income, but have to be adjusted for in the cash flow statement, as no cash has changed hands. The section at the bottom has some big amounts, related primarily to working capital increases or decreases. $2.5 billion in net cash outflow due to inventories and operating lease vehicles. How does this work? Remember that the cash flow statement explains how you got from the cash balance on the previous balance sheet to the cash balance on the current balance sheet. If inventory on the balance sheet goes up, then cash goes down. For the year ended December 31st, 2016, Tesla produced approximately 84,000 vehicles, an increase of 64% from the prior year, and has a target to increase the overall vehicle production to 500,000 vehicles in 2018. It's logical that inventory levels go up if a company is expanding at those rates. If inventory goes up, cash goes down, hence the negative number on this line item to signify a cash outflow. There is a partial offset in the accounts payable and accrued liabilities line. If you order more from your suppliers to keep up with increased vehicle production, then you receive more invoices from suppliers. If you have not paid those invoices yet by the end of the period, they will be reported as accounts payable on the balance sheet. If accounts payable go up, then cash goes up. Hence, this is a positive line item for cash flow. The last item that I would like to highlight in this section is customer deposits. Tesla is taking orders for Model 3 and asks customers for a deposit at the time they place an order for a vehicle. The amount of customer deposits on the balance sheet has more than doubled from the end of 2015 to the end of 2016. It is recorded as a liability on the balance sheet as the company has received the cash and owes the customer a vehicle in the future. The increase in customer deposits is reflected in the cash flow statement as an inflow. It increases Tesla's cash balance. Time to move to the next section of the cash flow statement, cash from investing activities, a net cash outflow of $1.4 billion. This is fairly easy to explain. Almost the whole category consists of purchases of property and equipment. Factory construction is on track to support the expected growth in vehicle production and deliveries. Third section of the cash flow statement, cash from financing activities, a net cash inflow of $3.7 billion. $1.7 billion from issuing common stock or equity. $1 billion as the net cash inflow between proceeds and repayments of convertible and other debt. $769 million cash inflow from collateralized lease borrowing. Once you have the three sections of the cash flow statement, operating, investing, financing, there is an important closing step, ensuring that the net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalents of $2.2 billion plus the opening cash balance of $1.2 billion equal the ending cash balance of $3.4 billion. If you are studying for an exam or preparing cash flow statements in real life, please make sure you include this finishing touch in your cash flow statement preparation. Back from the detail to the high-level cash flow statement overview. Tesla attracted financing in the form of debt and equity, which allowed them to invest. Tesla ended the year with more cash than they started with to continue investing and running everyday operations. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this example of how to review a cash flow statement, then please press the like button for me and share it with friends and colleagues. On this end screen, there are a few suggestions of videos you can watch next. Please subscribe to the Finance Storyteller channel so you can stay up to date on my latest videos for free. Thank you.